Hey everyone, Meet Kevin here. Welcome to beautiful sunny California. It's so sunny, it's blurry out there. But anyway, I want to talk about Fed Chair Powell. We are on autopilot here. Obviously, we got a hand right here on the wheel, and we're paying attention to the road. and we're buckled up too. But anyway, I want to give a quick update on what Federal Reserve Chairman Jerome Powell said today in his testimony before Congress. This is really important because anytime a Fed chair speaks, we can pick up indicators for where their belief is in terms of what interest rates are going to do in the future market. And if the Fed says anything that indicates they're going to reduce their bond purchases or that they're getting ready to ramp up interest rates, well, we're going to want to expect, or we should expect, a potential sell-off in the market. Now, today we had a sell-off in the market. The stock market got destroyed in the first 10 minutes of trading. We hit a solid bottom. We V-shaped recovered. Since then, we've had a little bit of softness again. So the day has been very, very volatile, to say the least. I have been buying in this market. I have not been selling in this market today. So about what Fed Chairman Jerome Powell said, though, what's very important. He said something that really crystallizes the Fed's position, and it has to do with unemployment, which this note about unemployment will give us guidance on interest rates. So to understand this, it's helpful to remember that the Federal Reserve has something known as a dual mandate, which is basically their two guiding principles, their rules for existing. Rule number one is maintaining price stability. So they don't want to come in and yank out the rug, so to speak, or take away the punch bowl too soon, because that leads to price instability. Just like they don't want to print an infinite amount of money, even though it kind of feels like they've already done that, because that also creates price instability. So you can go both ways and create price instability. But the other mandate that they have is maximum unemployment. Now, I'm sorry, maximum employment. That is, as little unemployment as possible and as much employment as possible. So as many people in jobs as possible. Now, the Fed has recently further clarified what they mean when they say maximum employment. And what they mean is they want all people to benefit. That means blacks, Hispanics, and women, three groups that are notoriously left behind in recessions, they want those groups to benefit from maximum employment. That means we're probably not going to see interest rates go up until the group that's suffering the most, women, Hispanics, and blacks, recover. Now, Jerome Powell gave us a stat that is actually pretty damning regarding this update. Right now, we know the unemployment rate is slightly below 7% on an entire sort of federal average, a national average. Jerome Powell believes that if we include discouraged workers, who are workers who have basically left the workforce because maybe their parents, and during the pandemic, they've just stopped working to take care of their children at home, or they can't find a job because the skills that are needed for jobs have changed. For example, and I'm just making something up, maybe you're a hotel property manager, somebody who helps people buy hotels, and there are maybe less people buying hotels right now, and maybe your skills have to retool to helping people buy houses, but you've got kids at home and you're staying out of the workforce because you don't have the time to reskill or retool, as they say, and so you're out of the workforce. That's just an example, maybe not the best example, but we're doing this on the fly. So, those people are considered discouraged workers. They don't actually show up in the official unemployment data. So when we say we're at 7% unemployment, that person who's left, they're like, sorry, like my skills just aren't needed right now. Like maybe I'll come back at some point in the future, but not right now. That person isn't counted. Jerome Powell says if we include that person, we're probably closer to 10% unemployment. But that's not the statistic that matters. The statistic that matters, that is going to have a huge weight on the future of how the Federal Reserve is expected to behave, is this one right here. The Fed says unemployment in the bottom quartile, so in the bottom 25% of Americans, is currently at 25%. 25% unemployment for the bottom 25% of Americans. That is horrible. That is miserable. And you might think like, oh, but Kevin, like what's to say that the Fed isn't just gonna leave them behind? I mean, government has been known for leaving people behind. This is true, but the Fed is also not the government. the Federal Reserve, before this pandemic hit, I've studied the Federal Reserve for years. Like, I love studying the Fed. One of the things that they've recently transitioned to before the pandemic, so I guess it's not that recent anymore, it's kind of weird to say, but like at the end of 2019, they spent a lot of time talking about how excited that they are that the people in the bottom quartile of the country, and especially a lot of women, blacks, and Hispanics, are much more able to, quote, participate in the economic recovery following the 2008 crash. And so basically the Fed's like, dude, it literally took 11 years for some of the people in the lowest economic thresholds to actually participate meaningfully in the economic recovery. And here Jerome Powell is saying, after another crash, we basically, and I'm paraphrasing here, we are not going to leave behind the bottom 25%. We are not going to stop supporting this economy until those people are benefiting again. To me, as a market investor, this is a very clear signal that we're probably, I mean, certainly at least 18 months away from seeing interest rates go up, but probably, I mean, based on statements like this, we could be 2 to 3 years away, even though we have those inflation fears coming. We know a few things about inflation, and this is a little bit of a recap, but it's worth mentioning. Federal Reserve Chairman Jerome Powell says we expect two big spikes in inflation coming. One, when we start comparing to base inflation over or base figures from last year, which is comparing to really low inflation data from March, April, May. So we're going to see inflation data come in pretty high on a year-over-year perspective in April, May, June, since they lag a month. And then these are traditional forms of inflation. The Fed looks at PCE. I know many of us, we see inflation in many different things. We see asset price inflation, real estate prices going up, stocks going up, food going up. Stocks and real estate obviously aren't included in inflation metrics. So that's asset price increasing, differentiated from the Fed's version of inflation. And then obviously, yeah, like food gets counted in, but it's averaged in with travel, which travels down. So it's a big mess, right? But anyway, the Fed's version of inflation is going to spike up. The Fed says already we expect that to happen. We're not going to do anything about it. And then the Fed says when the economy fully reopens, we're going to expect people will go out, get out and start spending again. And then we'll see a spike in inflation again. And we're not going to react to that either. So the Fed's totally cool with potentially seeing inflation at 2.5 to 3, maybe even 3.5% for a period of 3, 4, 5 months, depending, you know, these first 3 months here when we get higher inflation, but then also when we first open up, the first 3 months of being fully open. I know a lot of the country is open. I know a lot of people are business as usual already, but you know, once the country fully goes back to normal, we expect to see that inflation again. At which time, Fed Chair Jerome Powell's already saying, look, we're not even gonna respond to that. Like, we're not even considering that. And the big anchor that he revealed today is because of that 25% unemployment in the bottom, the bottom 25% having 20%, the bottom quartile, 25% unemployment. Yeah, matching, 25%, 25%, that's crazy. That is such a high unemployment number, the bottom quartile being at 25% unemployment. And, you know, in testimony before Congress, you have people like Elizabeth Warren saying, she tried to rag on Jerome Powell, and we watched this live, but she was trying to rag on him like, look, what are you doing to solve the K-shaped recovery? Like, there's such a, you know, growth in wealth of the rich people, but not of the poor people. Jerome Powell's basically saying, yeah, that's why we're going to keep rates low. But it's Congress that can help those people better, because Congress can provide relief to the bottom 25%. The Federal Reserve can only sprinkle money up around by running the money printer at the top of the pie. And then it kind of trickles down through the economy, and a lot of that unfortunately goes to the richest. But yeah, the bottom also benefits from lower rates, but much more slowly and more disproportionately. So the Fed's like, Elizabeth Warren, we agree with you. And we're not about to talk about the wealth tax you want, because that's not what the Fed does, but we're just gonna keep supporting until that end gets better. But Congress, you should get your act together, maybe actually consider passing some freaking stimulus. So anyway, hopefully this was helpful and insightful for you on what the HE double honky sticks Fed Chair Jerome Powell just said about the markets. If you found this helpful, consider subscribing, sharing the video, and folks, we'll see you in the next one.